In the world of germicidal UV, most people are happy with quite primitive measurements, handheld radiometers and dosimeters. But how is UV actually distributed in a real space? And how will a set of UV fixtures cover surfaces? In this video, we want to show how easy it is to model UV light much more precisely in the free lighting design software DIALux. This is an office space that I want to fit with some UV fixtures. I modeled the office in the DIALux Evo version 9.2. The purpose of installing UV fixtures would be to inactivate virus and bacteria in the space when no one is present. I'm not saying this is a good idea, this is just an example. DIALux is not really made for designing with UV light. In this video, we will use DIALux knowing that all numbers are right, but the units will be wrong. So for units, we need to be on top of things ourselves. I want to use this particular lamp. I opened the original Viso light measurement file in the Viso light inspector software. The overall UV output is about 5,000 milliwatts. And the main part of the UV light is emitted just around 255 nanometers, which is the classical UV germicidal wavelength. From this file, I can easily generate both IES and LDT files that are necessary inputs to DIALux. But before doing so, I want to filter away the small peaks of light that has no germicidal effect. Viso Light Inspector software allows you to do this in two ways. One way, the advanced way, is to apply a response curve specific to whatever germ you want to kill. This is similar to the way the V lambda curve is applied to results when calculating human eye response. For such response curves, you would need specialized scientific inputs. In this example, we would do it in a simpler way, that is just limiting the output to 254 nanometers plus minus 10 nanometers. Then I will generate an IES or LDT file. Normally this file will contain output information in photometric units such as lumen and candela. This time the file contains outputs in radiometric units, watts and watts per steradian. I'll just save the file in my downloads folder. Going back to DIALux, there are three groups of each four desks, each illuminated by suspended lighting fixtures. I've put a single calculation plane in the space, namely on top of these desks. This calculation plane will be used for evaluation of UV light distribution. Before experimenting with the UV light distribution, we need to think about the reflectances in the space. UV light is much easier absorbed in surfaces than visual light. There's not a lot of literature, but I put a link to a report in the comments that gives some ideas of which reflectances to use. Red brick and wooden boards would have a reflectance about 6%. High reflectance white paint is about 20%, but surprisingly, black painted wood is about 25%. Concrete and color-coded steel would be around 10%. In essence, if humans could see UV light, the world would probably look very different. In my sample office space, I will just use an average of 10% reflectance for all surfaces. Applying all of these rather low surface reflectances makes the space look very dark, and it will lower the general UV irradiation on all surfaces as almost no UV light bounces around. First, I will establish a new lighting scene and call it Lighting Scene 2 UV Lighting. Once this is done, I can just drag and drop UV fixtures anywhere by dragging and dropping the IES or LDT file into my space. Then I can adjust the position and tilt subsequently. I'm now ready to calculate the irradiance on the tabletop. Now the calculation is done and we can see the irradiance distribution. The trick is that all figures that are normally in lux and the isolux lines here on the desks are now in watts per square meter. We can also see that the figures are rather small. If we want to manipulate this output to show values in the units milliwatts per square meter, the shown values would be multiplied with 1,000. Instead of changing all numbers in the IES file, which is hard to do, it's much easier just to change the total flux of the luminaires to be in milliwatts instead of watt. I can pick the output from the original measurement file and put those 4,238 milliwatts into DIALux. I will now change the output for both UV lamps and recalculate. As we can see, the irradiance numbers on the desks are now about 1,000 times greater, and we must remember are now in unit milliwatts per square meter. In the result overview on the right-hand side, we can also see that the maximum is 409 milliwatts per square meter, and the minimum is zero. The zero values occur under the items on the top of the desks. You could remove those items, but on the other hand, maybe it's important to know that they do create shadows. Sometimes it's a good illustration of the UV distribution to shift to false color rendering. This image normally shows the luminance or brightness of the surfaces. As long as all reflectances in the space are the same, the color shown will be proportional to the irradiance. Therefore, in the false color rendition, we can see a good way of illustrating the UV light distribution on this space. From this image, it is evident that practically no UV light ever gets under the desks and everywhere else where deep shadows exist. But let's go back to the irradiance on the desktops and think about how this irradiance might inactivate a particular sort of germ. I'd like to look specifically into inactivation of COVID-19. From a specific peer-reviewed scientific article from September 2020, I read that we can try working with a specific 254 nanometer dose of 32 millijoule per square centimeter that will lead to 99.99% inactivation. With the irradiance pattern we just made, what might be the right dose time? In other words, how long should the UV lamps be on every night? The average irradiation is 242 milliwatts per square meter, which equals 0.0242 milliwatts per square centimeter. As joule equals watt times seconds, we can just divide the dose with the irradiance, the 32 millijoule per square centimeter divided by 0.0242 milliwatts per square centimeter, and we will readily get a dose time result of 1322 seconds, or about 22 minutes. As you can see from this demonstration, working with 3D radiance measurements and applying them to environments will give a much more detailed image of how UV lighting will work in practical applications. Visualizations will also give a clear impression of where irradiation is low and lead longer dose times. Thank you very much for listening. If you have any questions, please leave a comment or contact Viso Systems on info@visosystems.com. We'd be glad to help you.